Glamour Prestige presents Virtual Learning Party every Tuesday and Thursday starting March 24th, 2020 for students in grades 3 through 6, reading and English only.
Your hosts are Dr. Jacqueline Walker and Velvet Smith, who are ready to turn up for learning. Hey!
Hi guys, we missed you so much yesterday. Today is now Thursday, and today's lesson is about the main idea. You know what the main idea is all about? Well, usually we will propose a big question to you, like we did about drawing conclusions, asking you, what is the main idea? Or something about a big question that kind of gets you to think. But today, we're gonna have an interactive video that we got from Flowcabulary to help you answer that question.
And sometimes we struggle with the main idea because it's so many supporting details, so many things. We really just wanna know, well, what is it really all about? So we're gonna drop some rhymes from Flowcabulary and it's gonna tell us about the main idea.
All right, class, I know you're ready for the weekend.
Yeah!
Don't forget about your five-page paper.
No!
And make sure that you express your main idea and back it up.
Listen up, lend me an ear. The hot new thing is the main idea. Supported by the details to keep it all clear. The main idea is the reason that we're all here. Yeah, come on, lend me an ear. The hot new thing is the main idea. Supported by the details to keep it all clear. The main idea is the reason that we're all here.
Have you ever read something and when you got to the end,
yeah,
you didn't get the point? Nope, you didn't understand.
Uh-huh.
Well, let me break it down for the next time you read. There's gonna be three basic things you see. The subject, main idea, and the details. Sort of like a city, the house, the people.
The subject is the broad thing that it's about. The main idea.
What's that now?
It's the main thing the writer wants to say. It's the central point. You get it? Okay. You can often find it in the first couple lines, but it could be anywhere, so go find it. It's supported by specific details.
Yeah.
The facts and the sentences, be real.
Yeah.
They should add up to make the main idea, kid. They form up like cheerleaders in a pyramid. Like I just read an article called Bare Facts, and it talked about how they could be brown or black, polar or grizzly or another type. They're all good hunters and they know how to fight, cause they have big claws so they can catch fish and big sharp teeth that they eat with. And if they want to climb a tree to find something to eat, their super sharp claws are all that they need. See? Now let's break it down. I mean, let's dig deeper in the article I found. What's the subject?
Bears!
And what would be the main idea they had there?
The bears are good hunters, that's most important.
And how about the details they had to support it?
They have large teeth, paws, and claws.
And that's how you know hunting is a bear's job. Listen up, lend me an ear. The hot new thing is the main idea. Supported by the details to keep it all clear. The main idea is the reason that we're all here. Yeah, come on, lend me an ear. The hot new thing is the main idea. Supported by the details to keep it all clear. The main idea is the reason that we're all here.
I just read a story about a boy named Ben.
Okay.
On the first day of school.
Well, what happened then?
Ben clutched his new backpack and walked in with a big smile when he saw his old friends. Tried to play it cool when he saw his old crush.
Uh-oh.
But when she was close, his mind turned to mush.
What?
He liked his art teacher. That class was real fun. Ben was so worked up that he could hardly eat lunch.
Uh-oh. Now, what's the subject?
Ben's first day of school.
And what's the main idea? What's the author want to prove?
Ben's first day of school was exciting.
And details to back that up, where are they hiding?
When Ben saw his old friends, he was psyched. And he was nervous around the girl that he liked.
He even had a backpack that was brand new.
Now I get the main idea, can you?
We really hope that you like that song and all that information that you learned from Flowcabulary. I was really feeling the song. What about you?
Yes, I really like the song. What's the main idea?
And I hope that you were able to fill in the blanks that you had with your fill in the blank main idea sheet. But now, before we get into our mentor text, we want to tell you how to find the main idea. And we also want to do a little practice with you before we actually let you out on your own into main idea world. So how do you find the main idea? Before you read the title. What is the topic, is the text about? And then what is the topic?
During reading, you look for and carefully read the text features. Is the text fiction, nonfiction? You look for information, words, and pictures that are repeated.
And then after you read, you think about the most important parts that you have about the topic, and then what details or examples back up and support the main idea. All right, now it's time to practice. I'm going to do number one, and then Ms. Smith is going to do number two. It says, I can't wait until this weekend. We're going to my grandparents' house, and my entire family will be there. I will spend most of my time playing games with my cousins. We will always have such a good time together. The day goes by so fast, and by the end, we are all exhausted. But we still don't want to leave. Okay, what's the main idea of this passage? Is it A, weekends are times to travel? B, the writer enjoys spending time with family? C, the writer's grandparents live far away? Or D, the writer is sad to leave her cousins? So as I think about the information that I saw from the text and that I saw in the text, I have an idea, but I want to get Ms. Smith to help me out. Which do you think is the main idea of this passage?
Well, looking at the information that's in the text and thinking about doing reading, it says words that repeat and things that's going on. So I saw the writer likes to spend time with their family playing games, having such a good time together. The day goes by fast. And at the end, they're so exhausted or tired, but they still don't want to leave. I think the main idea is B, the writer enjoys spending time with their family because everything in the text says that that person likes to be with their cousins and family.
Okay, so Ms. Smith chose B, but now we're going to give you an opportunity to choose one. So right now, I need you to take about 10 seconds or less and circle the one that you think is the correct answer. Remember to use the things that you saw on the screen before, which talked about how to find the main idea. Okay, we hope you've had enough time, but if you haven't, you can always pause this video. But drum roll, please. The answer is B. The writer enjoys spending time with family. And we really hope that that's what you had for the answer. But now you're going to do another one with number two with Ms. Smith.
Wilbur and Orville Wright were brothers who were inventors, even from a young age when they built kites and bicycles. Many people credit the Wright brothers with designing and building the first successful airplane. In 1903, their first flight only lasted 12 seconds, but it continues to inspire people all over the world to learn about science and math, to work hard to realize their dreams, and to use imagination to achieve success. The main idea of this passage is A, the Wright brothers worked hard, B, the Wright brothers were inventors who have inspired many people, C, inventors build kites and bicycles, or D, the first flight was in 1903. I think I have an idea of the main idea, but I'll let Dr. Walker tell us what she thinks the main idea of this passage is.
Well, as I look at all of the answer choices out of the four, I know it's one that really sticks out to me. And the one that sticks out to me is actually B. And it says, the Wright brothers were inventors who have inspired many people. The reason why that sticks out to me is because in the second sentence, it says brothers who were inventors. So that lets me know that they were inventors. And then as I go down, it says that in 1903, their first flight only lasted 12 seconds, but it continues to inspire people all over the world to learn about science and math. It talks about dreams and using your imagination to achieve success. So my guess is that it is B, because all of that has all the information and the answer that relates right back to the text.
All right, it's time for you to write or circle your answer. So we're going to give you about 10 seconds and then we're going to come back with the answer. All right, a drum roll for the answer. And the answer is B. The Wright brothers were inventors who have inspired many people.
Hey guys, now it is time to see our mentor text for today, and it is called Pop, as Ms. Smith has it in her hands, and it is a narrative nonfiction. You know that a nonfiction story is a true story. When it's a narrative nonfiction, it is being told from the perspective of someone that is telling the truth about whether it be their life or their circumstances or history. So it is a narrative nonfiction, and it kind of reads like a narrator. But Ms. Smith is going to get you more excited about the book as she tells you just a little bit of information about it.
So when you're chewing gum or popping it, you don't even know where it came from. This book is going to tell you about the invention of bubblegum. Bubblegum has been around for a long time, and you're going to find out the real deal in this book, Pop, the invention of bubblegum, that's coming up next.
Pop!
Pop, the invention of bubblegum by Megan McCarthy.
On a small street in Philadelphia in the 1920s, there was a factory owned by the Wheeler family.
Inside the factory, lots of gum and candy were made. Working upstairs was a young accountant named Walter Diemer. His job was to add numbers and balance budgets. He knew lots about math, but not much about gum. There wasn't enough space in the building, so a new experimental laboratory was moved into the office next to Walter's. In came lots of breakers and pots and tubes. What could be going on?
The big secret was that the company was trying to make a new kind of gum. Chewing gum had already been around for centuries. Men in top hats and women in puffy dresses chewed gum for fun and to cure things like stomach aches. The ancient Greeks chewed the sap of the mastic tree.
And American Indians introduced early settlers to spruce tree resin, a sticky substance that could be chewed.
Oh, hi. Gum wasn't that exciting, but what if gum chewers could blow bubbles? Now that would be something. A world full of bubble gum blowers.
Every day Walter watched what went on inside the laboratory. There wasn't much progress. One day his boss Jester tore one of the kettles containing a gum experiment and said, "Watch that, will you?" After a while, I was not only watching it, I was doing it. Walter said he added a bit of this and a bit of that, but still nothing. Perhaps making the new gum was impossible after all, and soon Walter's boss had given up.
Walter had it. He spent months playing with different mixtures. Finally, something was happening. Bubbles. Big, glorious bubbles. The mixture needed flour, so Walter added a bit of flour, cinnamon, a dish of white wintergreen, a drop of vanilla. Could this bubble batch be bubblegum?
Walter put a wad into his mouth and began to chew. When the time was right, he blew a magnificent bubble. "I had it," Walter said. Excitedly, he passed out the mixture for his co-workers to try. We were blowing bubbles and prancing all over the place.
Only the next day, the mixture was as hard as a rock. It wouldn't blow a bubble worth a darn. But Walter didn't give up. Back to work he went after many more months of adding this and that. Top secret ingredients he would never share. Walter found what he was looking for.
It bubbled and popped. Could this batch finally be bubblegum? To finish off his grand creation, he needed some color. "Pink coloring was the only one I had at hand," said the inventor. So in it went.
a batch was cut into pieces and 5 pounds of it was brought to a local mom and pop store. It was the day after Christmas, and the kids who came into the store got the present of a lifetime. There were the first people in the world to try a bubble gum that worked. That day, Walter gave lessons on how to blow bubbles. Everyone loved bubble gum. When the kids discovered what it could do, it sold out that afternoon, Walter said.
Walter's bubble bubble was such a success that the Fleer Corporation made truckloads of delicious bubble gum. It was delivered to small stores and big stores alike.
After being promoted to vice president and then later returning from Flyer, Walter enjoyed the rest of his life in a relaxed manner. He was known to ride around on a giant tricycle and look to invite the next door kids over for what else? Bubblegum contests. Walter Dimmer never got rich from his invention, but he didn't seem to mind. Even I've done something with my life, he said. I've made kids happy around the world.
The end.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed the Mentor Text Pop, the invention of bubblegum. How exciting was it to learn about how bubblegum was really invented? I hope you've got to know all of the details about the invention of bubblegum and kept on your main idea hat so that you will be able to complete the next activities.
Okay. So we know you heard the Flocabulary song, and we did a review of what to look for the main idea. But now let's review exactly what the main idea and details are. The main idea is what the passage is mostly about. To find the main idea, you should ask, what is the text mainly about?
What information is in the title or subheadings?
What do I see in the illustrations?
Do I see the main idea in the first or last sentence?
And lastly, are there any words used repeatedly? Okay, you have read the book, and now it's time to check out your independent practice. So your independent practice comes exactly from the book, and you have the sheet in front of you. And it's Pop, the Invention of Bubblegum. And we've given you all the details. You just have to find the main idea. So it says, circle the best choice for the main idea based off of the supporting details. So I'm going to read some details, and so is Mrs. Smith.
All right, detail one. On a small street in Philadelphia in the 1920s, there was a factory owned by the Fleer family. And inside the factory, lots of gum and candy were made.
The next detail says there was a big secret that the company was trying to make a new kind of gum. Chewing gum had already been around for centuries.
And the third detail is Walter's Double Bubble was such a success that the Fleer Corporation made truckloads of delicious bubble gum.
So now, here is the moment of truth. You have to choose which one is the main idea based off of those details. So let's look at choice A. Pop is the true story of how bubblegum was invented.
Answer choice B. Pop is the true story of Walter Demere's childhood.
Or answer choice C. Pop is the true story of the creation of chewing gum. Okay, guys. We have to let you be on your own for a few seconds. You have to look back at all of the supporting details, and you have to look at all of the answer choices. So go ahead and think that through for a few. Okay, let's go through this together. So we're going to start using some test-taking strategies as well. So I'm going to choose one that I think is exactly not true, and I'm going to tell you why. So based on answer choices A, B, or C, Ms. Smith, I'm taking off C. And C says, Pop is the true story of the creation of chewing gum. And you want to know why? It's because in detail two, it says, that there was a big secret that the company was trying to make a new kind of gum. Chewing gum had already been around for centuries. So we know that can't be the main idea of the book because it said that it was already around for centuries.
Okay, so now we're left with A, Pop is the true story of how bubblegum was invented, or B, Pop is the true story of Walter DeMere's childhood. So when looking at these details that I have here, the answer that I think is the best correct answer is A, Pop is the true story of how bubblegum was invented. And when we're looking at the details, we can see that the Fleer Company had a factory that had gum and candy was being made there, and that Walter's Double Bubble was such a success that the corporation made truckloads of this delicious bubblegum. So I think that's the best answer because none of the details talks about Walter's childhood. So my answer is A, Pop is the true story of how bubblegum was invented. That is the main idea.
Okay, we've done the main idea and the correct choices of the answer is A, Pop is the true story of how bubblegum was invented. We really hope that you have that. But if you didn't, it's always time for you to go back and practice looking over your details and the main idea. So now, we want to review bubblegum review with just a question step. So the question step that I have today that Ms. Smith and I are going to talk about is, what is another good title for this story? What would another good title for this story be? And I want you at home to write down what you think another good title would be for the story. What do you think?
Maybe it could be bubblegum. Fact or fiction, the true story behind bubblegum.
That's a good one. Or maybe it could be pop, 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 how bubblegum was made. That could be one that works too. But we just want to also remember that anytime that we change the story or we change the title, it has to still be aligned with what the original story was about. We couldn't say that it would be called popcorn because it doesn't have anything to do with popcorn. It's about the bubbles that we pop with the gum.
Right. So remember, the title gives us a clue to the main idea. So your new title should always have something to do about pop. Bubblegum, the creation or invention of bubblegum.
Okay, guys, see you later.
Bye-bye.
Hey guys, we hope that you have enjoyed this lesson today about the main idea. So now that you reviewed the main idea, you know the main idea is what the story is mostly about. When you read the story and someone asks you now, what's the main idea? You're going to give them information of what the story was mostly about. You're going to tell them the key point that made the story the story. But on Tuesday, we're going to do
supporting details. And what do supporting details do? They hold up the main idea. Check back with us on Tuesday.